Hello students, from your dream catcher book, the third chapter we have is the story named The Tale of Peter Rabbit. Now students, from the name of the story, you can understand we have the name over here, Peter. So here in the story, the main character is Peter Rabbit. Okay, now students, have you ever forgotten your way to home? Did you remain calm or did it scare you? So this experience of Peter Rabbit we will see in the story, where he forgets his way to home and what happens with him, or how he reaches his home again, we will see in this chapter. But before that, let us have a brief introduction of the writer of this story. This story was written by Helen Beatrix Potter. She was born on 28 July 1866 in South Kensington in London in United Kingdom or UK. She died on 22nd December 1943. So students, as from her birth of place, you can understand that Helen Beatrix Potter was an English writer. She was an illustrator, natural scientist, environmentalist, and she is best known for her children's books featuring animals, such as the story that is given to you, The Tale of Peter Rabbit. You will see all the animal characters basically over here. Okay, so all the works that she had done were all having the animal characters. Now let us come to our story. What happens? Once upon a time, there were four little rabbits. Their names were Flopsy, Mopsy, Cottontail and Peter. They lived with their mother underneath the root of a very big tree. "Now, my dears," said old Mrs. Rabbit one morning, "you may go into the fields or down the lane, but don't go into Mr. McGregor's garden. Your father had an accident and he was put in a pie by Mrs. McGregor. Now run along and don't get into mischief. I am going out." Now see here, Mr. and Mrs. McGregor, they are the human characters in this story. And Mrs. Old Rabbit is just going out. And before leaving her home, she warns her children that they all can go play outside, but they must never go into Mr. McGregor's garden, because what happened, their father had an accident, and his father, that means the little rabbit's father, was put in a pie by Mrs. McGregor. Then old Mrs. Rabbit took a basket and her umbrella and went through the wood to the baker's. So where did she go? She went to the baker's. She bought a loaf of brown bread and 5 currant buns. Now, Flopsy, Mopsy and Cottontail, who were good little bunnies, went down the lane to gather blackberries. But Peter, who was very naughty, ran straight away to Mr. McGregor's garden and squeezed under the gate. First, he ate some lettuces and some French beans, and then he ate some radishes, and then, feeling rather sick, he went to look for some parsley. But round the end of a cucumber frame, whom should he meet but Mr. McGregor? Mr. McGregor was on his hands and knees planting young cabbages, but he jumped up and ran after Peter, waving a rake and called out, "Stop, thief!" Peter was most dreadfully frightened. He rushed all over the garden, for he had forgotten the way back to the gate. He ran on and went faster, but unfortunately he ran into a gooseberry net and got caught. Peter thought his end was near and shed big tears. Mr. McGregor came up with a sieve, which he planned to put on the top of Peter, but Peter wriggled out just in time. He rushed into the tool shed and jumped into a can. Mr. McGregor was quite sure that Peter was somewhere in the tool shed, perhaps hidden underneath a flower pot. He began to turn them over carefully, looking under each. Soon Peter sneezed, "Catty-scoo!" Mr. McGregor was after him in no time and tried to put his foot upon Peter, who jumped out of a window, upsetting 3 plants. The window was too small for Mr. McGregor, and he was tired of running after Peter. He went back to his work. Peter sat down to rest. He was out of breath and trembling with fright, and he had not the least idea which way to go. After a time, he began to wander about, going lippity-lippity, not very fast, and looking all around. He found a door in a wall, but it was locked, and there was no room for a fat little rabbit to squeeze underneath. An old mouse was running in and out over the stone doorstep, carrying peas and beans to her family in the wood. Peter asked her the way to the gate, but she had such a large pea in her mouth that she could not answer. He went back towards the tool shed, but suddenly, quite close to him, he heard the noise of a hoe. Scratch, 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 scratch. Peter scuttered underneath the bushes, but soon, as nothing happened, he came out and climbed up upon a wheelbarrow and peeped over. The first thing he saw was Mr. McGregor hoeing onions. His back was turned towards Peter, and beyond him was the gate. Peter got down very quietly off the wheelbarrow and started running as fast as he could go along a straight walk behind some black currant bushes. Mr. McGregor caught sight of him at the corner, but Peter did not care. He slipped underneath the gate and was safe at last in the wood outside the garden. Peter never stopped running or looked behind him till he got home to the big tree. So students, this was your story about the tale of Peter Rabbit. How he forgets his way to home and how he reaches again is all given over here. So this story was quite fun, and I hope you understood this. If you find any problem, then ask me. Okay? Thank you.